Pteranodon is one of the most popular extinct creatures of them all, swooping and screeching through movies and TV, capturing the imagination of people of all ages. But some of the most popular creatures are the ones with the most misconceptions. Today we'll discuss some of the things you might believe about pteranodons that are completely false. First off, I want to say this. Quit calling pterosaurs dinosaurs. Pterosaurs were not dinosaurs. Non-avian dinosaurs could not fly, and they didn't live exclusively in the water. Mosasaurs, plesiosaurs, pterosaurs, etc. were not dinosaurs, and if people keep calling them dinosaurs, I think I'm gonna start screaming. Okay, so, now that we got that out of the way, let's bust some myths about Pteranodon. I'm sure you all know what Pteranodon looks like. Big, scaly dinosaur birds, right? Absolutely not. Pteranodons, like most pterosaurs, were covered in a thin, hair-like filament, almost like down feathers, but they weren't used for flight like those of birds. Many archosaurs, like pterosaurs and dinosaurs, had coverings like this, and it seemed to be used mostly for thermoregulation, that is, heating and cooling the animals. Scientists are sometimes able to examine these fibers and even reveal the colors of the pterosaurs by looking at the melanosomes, the melanin-bearing organelles. I'm not smart enough to know exactly how they do it, but scientists have discovered that one species of pterosaur was probably covered in reddish-brown plumage. So, no, pterosaurs were not the scaly monsters you see in movies and TV. They were actually quite soft and fuzzy. And that leads us to another annoying trend in pop culture, portraying pteranodons with beaks filled with deadly teeth. This ticks me off almost as much as calling dinosaurs pterosaurs. You'll see movies with pteranodons as the monsters, and they'll add teeth in to make the animals scary and lethal looking. But guess what? The name Pteranodon literally means wing without tooth. It's in the name. Some pterosaurs do have teeth, yeah, and there are tons of unique and awesome pterosaurs to use in your movie rather than mutilate the poor pteranodons. How do so many people get this wrong? Okay, what's next? Another thing movies often portray in pteranodons is their gripping, eagle-like feet, perfect for lifting terrified humans off the ground. But again, this would be impossible. Pteranodons weren't just big birds of prey. They didn't use their feet for grabbing, and used them instead for walking. Their feet were flat, rather like our own, and were never used to snatch prey from the ground. They preferred to use their beaks for catching prey, which, by the way, wasn't humans or dinosaurs or whatever else. Pteranodons were most likely piscivorous, meaning they ate fish, possibly diving like seabirds into the water to catch tasty fish. We know this due to fossilized fish bones or scales that have been found in the stomachs of pterosaur fossils. In 1994, it was found that pteranodons were very top-heavy and had similar skeleton structure to diving birds. They could possibly have folded their wings up and dove into the ocean. The large crest atop its head might have been to help steer it through the wind, or possibly it was an identifier, letting other pteranodons know that it was a pteranodon too. Or it could have been large and colorful to attract mates, like the feathers on modern-day birds. We still don't really know. And the last myth we'll bust today, Pteranodon was not pterodactyl. Many people use the word pterodactyl to describe all pterosaurs, especially Pteranodon, but surprisingly, pterodactyls didn't even exist. The name pterodactyl was derived from the name of the genus Pterodactylus, the first pterosaur to be discovered, but there was no pterosaur that was just called pterodactyl, and it definitely wasn't Pteranodon. Pterodactylus was a lot smaller than Pteranodon, and it did have teeth, along with no head crest. And honestly, Pteranodon deserves to be known by its real name. It's such a cool, awe-inspiring creature, and I encourage you to look it up for yourself. And come back here for 3 videos weekly, all about prehistory, dinosaurs, and, well, mostly dinosaurs. But for now, Paleo Luke out.